Assalamualaikum, welcome to Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. Guys, today there is no recipe, but I want to share a few stuffs about how to choose your vegetables wisely, because choosing vegetable is actually an important criteria before you begin any kind of cooking, and this will be helpful for the beginners as well. So please share as much as possible. Let's begin with onions first. Here, this onion is too dry and too flaky. Never go for such onions. Also, I'll show you, this onion is, I will call this a twin onion because there are like two onions growing together, stuck to each other. These kind of onions have very less shelf life. So see, I'll show you an example of that. Look at this. This is again a twin onion, which has got spoiled, and I'm sure these kind of onions can never last long in your shelf. So if you want your onions to be, you know, good and last longer, at least for 10 days from the date you buy, then go for something like this. This is the best one, you know, not too flaky, not too dry. And when you hold it, you feel it is little heavier and it will be very juicy and it will make you cry very well. Okay, next is the tomatoes. Everyone knows, even a small child knows that he needs to pick up only red looking tomatoes. But opt for, you know, as much as possible red looking tomatoes for sure, and a round tomato, not an oval tomato. Round tomatoes are good for cooking and oval is good for making any sauces or chutneys or like that. Okay, and please avoid such you know, tomatoes with the green and the dots and all, because they are not so good. Next is the garlic. Any garlic which is opened up like this, don't go, because they will have very bad shelf life and they can spoil very easily, because we store the garlics outside, not inside the refrigerator. Always go for which is, you know, closed. See, this is open and it has very bad fungus in it. Next is, we will go for the spinach part. I always opt for you know, fresh, nice, fragranced spinaches. This is called mat ki bhaji. I don't know what you people call it. It's very tasty when you cook it in a dry method. I will show you a recipe for this as well. And this is another kind of spinach which is similar to what I have showed you previously. And this one also goes very good with lentils as well as with you know, dry cooking. Next is palak. We all know, especially we Indians know the flavors of palak. So palak is my favorite too, especially the palak paneer. Okay, and this I called, like we call this bhaji as kulfe ki bhaji, and in English it is roka. So kulfe ki bhaji, it's delicious when you cook it with toor dal. You know, when you make dal, just at the end of the dal, just cut and add this. It will be very delicious. This is called fenugreek bhaji, spinach, you know, fenugreek spinach, which is methi ki bhaji, and it goes very well with fish curries also, guys. So you should try that. Inshallah, soon I will share the recipe with you. Always go for fresh looking, you know, with beautiful color and nice texture and smell of the spinach. This is called soi ki bhaji, or we also call it like fennel spinach or dill leaves or wheatgrass leaves. These goes very good with eggs, especially if you're making eggs bhuji, then go for that, and biryanis too. Now when you choose your onions, I mean spring onions, please go for which is smaller and which has very thin you know, leaves in it. It tastes very good. Next is the radish. Radish, always go for the ones with the spinach. It tastes really good when you cook it along with the spinach, and also check if it is nice and heavier when you pick it up. More heavier, it's more juicier and it's more delicious. And thanks to my father-in-law, because he taught me how to buy a radish. Thank you, Dad. Okay, next is the bottle gourd. See, here if you find any cracks in them, please don't go for it. Go for a nice stiff and a heavier one with the perfect shape, you know, any and the color also. Don't go for too light colors, and don't go for one which is too soft and spongy. Don't go for that. Go for a heavier one. It's juicy and nice. Don't go for such shapes as well. Next, coming to brinjal, wrinkled skin, no. And dots like this, no. Always go for a fresh looking brinjal like this and has no dots in it, because they might contain small insects inside. Next is turai. Turai is one of my favorite, and how I choose turai is it should be stiff, and when you open the knob, just try to cut open the knob with your hand itself and try to taste the corner of it using your finger or something. If it tastes sweet, then go for it. If it tastes sour, then don't go for it. It will be very bitter when you cook. Next is tinda. Tinda is also called apple gourd or Indian squash in English. And any tinda which is nice and green and stiff, not too soft, not too hard, go for it. If it is too soft, it will be spoiled like this, or it can also be red in color, which will not taste good when you cook. But if it is just perfect, then it will look like this when you cut and will be very tasty. Next is snake gourd. Snake gourd is one of super fantabulous vegetable, because it helps you to detoxify and improve digestion. So it should be a little softer and not too hard, and it should be clean like this. If you don't get clean like this, you clean it up at home. It's very simple and very easy. And next is the drumstick. Yes, South Indians' favorite, North Indians' favorite, all are Indians' favorite. We need to choose drumstick wisely. Just give a slight twist and see if it is soft, twisting very well, go for it. If not, then don't go for it. No going for the hard ones. Go for very soft ones. Next is cauliflower. Always opt for cauliflowers which are, not having gaps. The flowers should not have gap in between them, and little bit of brownness it's okay, you can clean it off, but it should look something like this. Even the broccoli, it should, everything should be bunched up. You should pull it apart. It should not be loose, If it is loose, don't go for it. Insects can be inside and it will be spoiled. Next is cabbage. Always go for a cabbage which is lighter in weight, because the more heavier is the more bigger the root inside it. So don't go for the heavier one. Always go for the lighter one. So you get flakes also, too many flakes also. Otherwise, only the root will be heavy and no flakes in it. So it's waste of buying such cabbage. Next is beetroot. Beetroots are, very, very sweetest vegetable. I love beetroot. While cooking, I just fall in love with them. Go for something like this, which is nice, clean, and when you touch it, you should feel it's nice, and it should be heavy as well. Such beetroots, which are very light, they'll not be good. Next is chocho. Few dots here and there is fine with the chocho. Chocho is also called as chayato. Chayato. Okay. Next is beans. Beans. Nice green in color, and when you break them, it should make this sound. Exactly. Anything like this, don't go for it. Nice green in color, no brown spots in them, please. Next is ladyfinger. One of my favorite dishes is ladyfinger masala fry. That's the right ladyfinger. Soft, spongy when you touch, and soft, no thorns or pricks in your finger when you touch them. And anything like this, brown spotted or dots like this, and when you try to break them from the knob, you can see it's not breaking, and it's very bad. Don't go for that. Always go for something which is soft and crispy when you feel it, and when you try to break it also, you should feel that sound, that nut crack sound, tuck. Okay. Next is capsicum. Very clean skin, no wrinkles, and just perfect. And light weighted. Okay. More weighted means more seeds, and it will not taste good. Less weighted means less seeds, it will taste good. Next is jalapenos, one of my favorites. I always use them in my pizzas and any sauces or something like that. Don't go for wrinkled one. Always go for the soft ones like this. And next is yam. Yum, yum, yum. It's very yum, yum when you fry them in very light oil. Don't go for too much brown and too many spots on it. Don't go for such kind of a yam. Go for one which is very nice and clean, because that nice and clean white looking yam is a fresh yam, and this one is a very old yam. See, it's already started to spoil. So very less shelf line and too much of yam will go away. This is the best one to buy for you. Okay, next is potato. Everyone's favorite. Children's love it the most. See, that's little green in color. Always go for potatoes which are little smaller in size, unless and until you want to make french fries. Go for bigger ones and ensure that, you know, it doesn't have any green shades on it. Green shades means no proper starch. No proper starch means it will not taste good. So always go for something which is small and you know, perfect brown color. And baby potatoes, you all know how they are. So I don't think you need any explanation in that. So that's how you choose a wise potato. Okay, next is arbi. What is arbi called in English? It's called kolakashiya. Okay, any doubled arbi or anything spoiled like this, please don't go for it. Go for a clean arbi like this, and this is the best one for you to buy, this type of arbi, which has no doubled up and no scratches or nothing. I mean, no spoils or something. Okay, here I want to show you how I preserve my herbs and my spinaches. What I do is, as soon as I reach home, I just try to cut them down and let them rest for like 10 to 15 minutes minimum and maximum 1 hour. And then I store them in the airtight container using a tissue like this. And this can be kept in the refrigerator up to 10 days also. They'll be just fresh as they are now. And drumstick also, what I do is, as soon as I bring it home, I try to clean them and wipe them nicely and cut them into small chunks as I'm showing you, and then put them in the box and again in an airtight box and, you know, refrigerate them. And after 5 days also, if I take, it's just as fresh as this. And I also store sometimes in Ziploc bags when I'm running out of boxes. And any leftover veggies, I store like that. So you can also try this recipe, and please do share among your friends, your neighbors, your groups, and please let everybody learn and you also learn. And please share as much as possible and subscribe to my channel for more is coming up in Cooking is Fun with Firdaus. Stay tuned. Allah Hafiz till then.